How you doing? Woo-hoo! Oh, lovely, lovely. As Kerry said, my name is Rajiv. That's spelled R-A-J-I-V. It's not a traditionally English name, no. No, it actually comes from ancient Rome. Yeah, where it means Raj the Fourth. Roman numerals gag. Yeah. So early in the show. If you didn't get that one, maybe read a book. Education is the passport to the future. You know who said that? Malcolm the Tenth. You might be thinking, he's pretty clever. Not clever enough to think of a third. Yeah, not great. Just came back from Glasgow. Just came back from Glasgow. I'm keeping it on. Yeah, so what? It was a good time. Who went? Woo-hoo! Who watched it on the TV? Woo-hoo! Who did none of those things? Woo-hoo! Yeah, legends. Legends. Tell them they're legends. More Glasgow for us. It was cool. It was a really good time. Not to say it wasn't without its vices. I think I saw more fuck racism signs than I saw actual people of colour. And I'm not a man. I've done many white things in my time. So to shock me, you gotta get up pretty white in the morning to shock this guy. It was probably the whitest thing I have done since I went gooseberry picking with my friend Benedict. Yeah. But no, it was a good time. It was a good time at Glastonbury. Things are going pretty well for old Rajiv. The apples I eat are very shiny. Yeah, fair enough. Yeah. I'm a comedian now, which is a lot of fun. It wasn't always the dream. When I was a kid, I didn't want to be a comedian, no. I wanted to be a sarcastic pet cat to a teenage witch. Yeah, you can get from that. I was a big television child, I loved TV. I was about 7 years old when I sort of started sitting increasingly close to the television, increasingly close until I was about, like, I don't know, a foot away from the TV. And my mum looked at my dad and said, I think there's something wrong with him. And my dad said, yeah. And he's sitting really close to the TV. No, I needed glasses. I've been a glasses boy ever since then. I love having glasses, though. I think they sort of suit my face, so I'm very happy with them. I always wanted to get those transition lenses, though. I thought those were really cool. Never really, you know, so those are, you think you're dealing with like a businessman, catch him in a sunbeam, it's like, whoa, sunglasses. Oh, did you bring a skateboard or something? Nice. But I always wondered, if they have the technology for that, why not like take it to the next step? I want to buy like a string vest, catch it in the cold, like turns into a ski jacket, something like that. Yeah, come on, open your mind, boffins. What are you going to do? Cure something? Nah, yeah. So glasses. Yeah, I got these glasses now. I bought these a couple of years ago. I was told they were fuckboy glasses. Fuckboy glasses, that's what I thought. But when I walk down the street, people don't shout fuckboy at me. They shout Harry Potter. So it turns out Harry Potter, I was like, oh, those seem like pretty different things. But then we think about it, actually, Harry Potter is a guy who, like, when his chances failed with his friend, because she was dating his other friend, decided to sleep with that friend's sister. So, something of a fuckboy, the fuckboy who lived. Thanks, Frances, who wrote that joke. She's great, she's a nice lady, buy her a beer. Sorry to mention Harry Potter, I didn't want to kill the vibe, but a boy's gotta have material, right? I know J.K. Rowling's been under a lot of flack recently, but I've had beef with her for some time. Actually, for about 10 years now, because I don't know if you remember, after a couple of years after that final book came out, she posted this tweet which said, by the way, even though I never mentioned it in the books, I want you guys to know that Dumbledore was gay. And we were also supposed to be like, yes, thank you, pride, emoji, flag. Yeah, so, but I couldn't help but feel like, hey, if he was gay, couldn't you have mentioned it in the books? They were long enough. Just have like a, just throw it in passing. Like Harry popped up to Dumbledore's office and Dumbledore was just making out with some dude. He's like, oh shit, sorry, I'll come back later, man. Move on. But no. I don't like that because I think what she's trying to do there is retcon diversity without maybe doing the hard work first time round. I don't think people should be allowed to get away with that. Also, if you're going to do that, why stop there? She'd just be like, yeah, Dumbledore was gay and one of the Death Eaters was black. One of the Dementors was Jewish. And one of the house elves was trans. Not trans. I don't know, maybe I'm giving her a hard time. Maybe she's, you know, I learned a lot of things from those books too. From the first one, especially. First one, I learned that Americans don't know what a philosopher is. Yeah. But that's not to say there weren't like gaps in the plot that maybe should have been filled. For example, in the first one, I imagined that there were a lot of eye rolls at Hogwarts when Professor Quirrell came back from his gap year wearing a turban. Kind of gloss over that, but I think they'd have been talking about it, you know, in the staff room, being like, hey, Quirrell, you're back. Something different about you. Oh, yeah, new harem pants, nice. Get in here, you dickhead. Yeah, Harry Potter stuff. What else was us? I'm a very vain lad. You would be too. I don't understand the embarrassment around vanity. To put it in context for you guys, you know that song, You're So Vain? Well, I think if I'd written it, it would have been better. I don't understand why people are embarrassed about vanity. There's some great vain people of history. Most famous, Richard of York. Richard of York gave battle in vain. But most people don't know... the full details of that story. In fact, it's quite a sad story. Richard of York led his men into battle, thought things were going to go well. Things went pretty poorly. You know, they were completely outnumbered. He was struck down quite early, hit, knocked off his horse, blade across the chest, lying on the ground, bleeding out as sort of his men are getting, same things happening to them. And he was lying on the ground, staring up the sky, horrible stormy day. And he was thinking to himself, you know, not only am I facing certain death, but I've led my men into death, all for nothing. What a horrible way to go out, you know? And he was looking up at the sky, but just at the last few moments of his life, the clouds parted. And the rain sort of stopped for a second, and there was this beautiful rainbow. And they say that his last words as he looked up at the sky were, I'll never remember all those colors. Thanks very much, guys. Take care.